Hello, and welcome back to Let's Play Guard Duty. Blind. I am Amethyst Lunatari. I figured out what to do off screen. I was kind of close. I had two ideas with this thing. That, it should always be facing northwest. And then we should head northwest. Or it should be heading north, and we should head northwest. I think I might have thought that you could even go north, but you know what? I did some experimenting. I'm pretty sure this was one of my guesses, but we want to go, we want to have north facing north, which makes sense, right? And then we want to go northwest, so which so far is this way.
Right, so, which way?
The one thing I didn't realize is that this keeps changing. For now, it's fine. So, northwest is this way.
It all looks the same.
Sure does. Now, it's changed here. It's moved to west, so we need to move it back to north, and then northwest is now left. And it's changed again. The red is heading south, so we need to move this, the red facing north again. So now northwest is right.
According to my compass, the mountains should be right ahead.
Easy peasy lemon squeezy, as long as you know what to do. It's not even that long. But I did experiment with it off screen so you guys wouldn't have to sit through 15 minutes of me trying to figure this stuff out. Get to the skull-capped mountain. Okay. So we know we're not long, no longer lost in the snow, somehow. I guess now, because we see the mountains right ahead, he said, something like that. Now here, on in is blind. I haven't looked at this stuff, but just the fact that we found anything makes me think that we might not need the compass anymore. But I'm just going to check it anyway. It's still facing north. So we've got a frozen helmet, a frozen knight, a tree, which you'll need to look at.
His helmet's frozen into the snow. No use. It's stuck. Poor guy's frozen solid.
Yeah.
Poor guy's frozen solid.
Okay.
Fiddlesticks. There's no way I can move him on my own.
I don't know. Can he perhaps be brought back to life? I don't even know. He's a pack sack.
There's a discarded pack sack frozen into the snow.
I'm actually not familiar with that word, pack sack. It sounds a lot like knapsack. But you can't sleep
Let's
in
see.
This.
Ooh, a fancy dagger. Looks like it'll be worth a pretty penny. There's also some cereal oats. Well, it's better than nothing, I guess.
Cereal oats.
Cereal oats. They're a bit dry.
Hmm.
Some sort of fancy dagger.
Well, it's obviously this guy's pack. So that was his weapon. He would have brought a sword, though, being a knight.
Looks like this is the way to the mountain.
I like that we can even examine the direction out. I think we just crossed that off our list. That's the times we hear scribbling and there's nothing added. It's him crossing it out.
This way leads back to the snowfields.
I know.
It sure is dark in there.
Nothing to look at? Doesn't look like we can go any further in there. Or over there. Ooh, look at that. Would you write, Tondbert? Break into the creepy tomb with a little picture. Pressure pad. Creepy door.
Those things look heavy. There's a strange sigil engraved into the motif. Looks like the same one in that creepy book. This has got to be the place.
It's gotta be it, babe.
Some sort of plate with a fancy sigil on it. Must be something to do with that door mechanism. Some sort of plate with a must be something.
Yeah. Do we scroll over? Oh, a goat.
Poor guy looks starved. Hey, buddy. Poor thing. You must be starving.
So here's another sigil.
Some sort of plate with must be something to do.
Yeah. Strange gems.
These sure look like they're worth a few, Bob. Theremin's worth more to me than all the gems in the world. So close now.
But I don't even know if she knows he exists.
These sure look like they're worth a Theremin's so.
Alright, same thing. Oh, it opens a little. Ah, and it closes. Blood, look at that.
Those things look heavy. There's a strange sigil engraved into the motif. Looks like the same one in that creepy book. This has got to be the place. Hey, buddy. Poor thing. You must be starving.
Well, if he's hungry, maybe he would like some of this stuff. But we need something to weigh down this plate. I mean, don't forget, I played Dungeon Master, and Chaos Strikes Back, and Legend of Grimrock, which I believe there's a few pressure plates there as well. We need to hold down these pressure plates, probably all of them, to open this door. I don't know what to do about the third one, but maybe we can get the goat to stand there if we put the oats. Is there anything down here? No. I don't know what to do with the last one, but...
Nah, that'll just make the cereal all soggy.
Mwah.
Nah, that.
It's a good idea.
Nah, that. Don't think that needs to be stabbed.
I don't think that'll work.
I'm sure he's not gonna kill it. I just want to see what he says.
What do you want me to do? Stab him? Blimey.
Blimey. Yeah, pretty psychotic of us, isn't it? Creepy door. Well, I don't want to waste them. Let's just save before. I don't think this is the kind of game that puts you in an unwinnable state, but just in case it might be near the end. I don't know if we're near the end, but I heard it was a relatively short game.
You hungry? He likes me.
Of course he likes you. You're feeding him.
He's adorable. So fluffy. I'll leave him be.
So now, can we put it there? Now he'll put it there.
Come here, fella.
All of a sudden it won't be soggy. And then if we stand here... It's going to make a difference.
Don't think that needs to be stabbed.
Those things look heavy. There's a strange sigil. It looks like this has got to be.
I don't need to take a bearing of that.
maybe... Wait right there. No, wait. Fine.
He's adorable!
They came from this way? Maybe we can get the helmet out with the dagger. Just cut it, the ice.
Honestly, I've not much use for an icy helmet. If I find a use for it, I can always come back.
There is a use for it to weigh down the pressure point.
Drat! The ice is too thick to make a dent. I'd freeze to death before I cut him loose.
Oh yeah, the goat is inventory.
This fella seems pretty cooperative.
Use goat with goat.
I don't think he'd like that.
You don't think he'd like us using goat with goat? No, not...
You
feeling strong? Oh. Oh, I thought we chose goat again.
Pow!
Oh, he knocked
nice work. Let's move him somewhere warmer.
Can we? Okay, so... Use goat with frozen helmet.
Honestly, I've not... If I find a use for it...
Okay, so we're gonna move the guy. I gotta keep doing this? Alright.
This could take a while.
Thank you. A while later. Thanks, game! Break into creepy tomb. Still there. Alright, so... left. We can only move him left. At some point we need to move him up. Up. There you go. Yay! Okay, so now I'll put some oats here.
Come here, fella.
Oh. I don't even need to step in the middle one.
Sheesh, sure is hot in here.
Princess Theremin? Are you kidding me? I'm gonna save. Because this is a crucial juncture here. Magma.
Do not want to go near that. It's so hot. Kind of reminds me of the forge back in Wrinklewood. I sure hope everyone's doing okay.
So there's a bridge, there's a chain.
Those things are huge! Looks like it goes on forever! Definitely too big for me to move. I am not touching that!
Good idea.
More candlesticks without any candles. Weird. It's the princess! I need to get her out of here, pronto!
Yep. Anything else? Ornate pointy thing?
Some sort of nasty looking pointy thing. Sharp and pointy, but far too heavy for me to move. I'll need to find something else to cut Theremin loose.
I have a dagger.
Not sure what I'm gonna do with a candlestick. Plus, it looks real heavy. Keep it together, Tondbert.
Jump. Oh. A grate.
Those bars must be made of some seriously tough stuff to withstand that heat. It's too far for me to reach. Not that I'd want to touch him anyway.
A crank.
Some sort of rusty old crank. More candlesticks without any candles.
Sharp looking thing.
Some sort of sharp looking thing.
They look the same as the ornate pointy thing.
Sharp and pointy, but far too heavy for me to move. I'll need to find something else to cut Theremin loose.
To the rescue!
Theremin! Oh god! Please be breathing. Please be breathing. It's me. It's Tondbert. I'm here to save you. I need to find a way to cut these bindings. Fast.
All right.
Come on, come on.
Is she breathing? Uh-oh.
This blade is so blunt.
Here comes Palpatine.
What is this, a butter knife? Come on!
A butter knife.
Don't mind me.
Just mind me.
The irony. You're the fool that let me into the gates, aren't you?
He doesn't remember
that. All the king's horses and all the king's men were busy, I presume.
Hey, back off!
Oh dear, you're going for it, aren't you? Throw over your shoulder, push me aside, and walk right out of here like a hero.
Don't come any closer!
Fool.
Uh-oh. Oh, he's doing the force thing, choking. Not good.
Why am I sick of you two good types?
We're sick of you evil types.
You're all the same. You take one look at me, you fake. Oh, pasty guy with eyeliner. Wears a cloak black as death.
He wears eyeliner.
Clearly up to no good.
Well, we're right.
I'll have you know I have big plans for my eternal reign of immortality. Just you wait. The lands will be much better off for it.
Don't think that's true.
Speaking of which, how exactly did you get here? Can't have taken the normal route. I mean, sure of that.
Someone needs to help.
Wait.
Maybe the knight will thaw out from the magma.
Oh my god.
Being close to it.
Do you have any idea how long I've been looking for this? And to think you brought it right to me.
You're looking for it.
First class effort, I must say.
Oh crap.
Well, that makes things a lot easier. Time to get started, I guess. I still can't believe you brought me the sacrificial dagger.
What?
Just about the only thing you could have done to make this situation worse.
Oh god. What about the crank? I didn't mess with the crank.
Look, it's even got the sigil rare right on the hilt. It's just like the book.
I didn't notice that.
The king will never forgive you. You know that. You'll have to go into hiding. Run away as far as those little legs can take you.
I'm hoping
well,
night.
This must be really frustrating for you, eh?
Thaw out, knight. Thaw out.
To think you got this far. A good effort, I must say. Well, time to test out the dagger you so kindly donated.
Oh, God. No!
This must be really hard for you to watch.
It is.
I won't tell anyone if you close your eyes.
Oh, God.
Seat, Racht, Sap, Demos, Das! Come to me!
That's horrible. Oh god.
Oh god, it feels good to be back.
Now I don't know, maybe I should have messed with the crank first. Maybe this is, seems like it was supposed to happen. Because this is what leads to the world being the way it is in 2074. What happened to all these people? Are they dying?
Last one. Found this thing stalking the gates. Seems it was following us.
Oh,
these meatbags ain't so smart.
So much spirit for such a prophetic sack of meat and bones. A pity. Prepare a feast.
Did the king turn into that, or is it just something else? And they killed the king. Our world is lost. A land once blessed with life now suffocates in concrete. Humanity cowers under the rule of one, a being exempt from the burdens of mortality. For 1,000 years he has plagued this earth like a disease with no cure. He who feeds on the souls of the living. Act 3, Guardian Duty. Huh. Is this the guy from the beginning? With the gun? Made like dystopian cyberpunky or post-apocalyptic cyberpunky. Obey. Ah yeah, seems more dystopian now.
HQ, come in.
Starborn, report.
General, I've secured entry into the facility.
Well done, Agent. Sit rep, please.
I fear we may have a problem. There's some sort of sentry here. A tracked robot. The technology seems crude, to say the least.
As we expected, our informant has assured us they will not fire on sight.
Well, that's a relief.
There should be a large statue, one composed mostly of stone. Do you have visual?
Sure, I see it. Seems to be hooked up to some sort of power source.
Exactly as we predicted. That's the processing AI. Starborn, you're going to need to pose as one of the condemned citizens. One of those poor souls due for processing.
This
the
looks
bio
like...
is already on the system. All you have to do is declare yourself.
You're saying I can just walk right up to that thing?
We have it under good authority that you can, Agent. Our informant is waiting for you on the upper level. Do you need me to rebrief you? I'll patch you through to Rugrat for the details on that bio.
Rugrat.
Good luck, Agent.
This is like
hey,
Metal
boss?
Gear Solid.
How's it look?
Creepy, to say the least.
Just like Metal Gear Solid.
General said you have the details on the bio.
Right. So you're posing as one of the citizens called for processing. Poor souls get rounded up and strapped into a think tank. Their life force is literally drained straight out of them.
This is why we've got to stop this guy.
Exactly. You need to listen closely. Each citizen is identified by a series of numbers and characters. Our informant has pre-assigned an ID for processing.
Okay.
Get it wrong, and this whole operation is compromised.
No pressure, then. Right, give me the ID.
You're posing as citizen 0138...
What?
Well, it's just the last number is faded.
Faded? Are you kidding me?
Okay. It looks like it could be an 8, or maybe a 9. It's kind of hard to make out.
You're not exactly filling me with confidence, kid.
Oh, it'll be fine. Just go with your gut. The odds are in your favor, after all.
It's a 1 in 10 chance.
Look, we'll get this coffee mopped up, and we'll give you a call once the paper's dried. Now, these things always work out. Don't sweat.
Yeah.
Coffee.
Did I say coffee? I meant, okay, I spilled coffee on the intel. Just do
what?
Your thing, boss. You got this.
0, 1, 3, 8, and something that might be a 9 or an 8. Great.
Remember, boss, keep a clear head. The system's limited, but ruthless.
I'll keep that in mind. Starborn out. Approach the AI, state my citizen ID, and make my way to the upper levels. Here goes nothing.
Okay, I wrote it down. I don't know if we need... if I need to have it written down, but I wrote it down. Wait. Okay, so we have a gun.
Starborn, what is it?
Oh, cool. There's something I've been meaning to ask you.
General, there's something I've been meaning to ask you.
You have my ear?
Permission to speak freely, Mom.
Go ahead, Agent.
Okay, so I'm in this. 110%, but it's just...
Spit it out, Agent.
Do you really think it's possible? I mean, traveling through space and time. It all sounds a bit like science fiction to me.
Look around you, Agent. This is real. If we don't do something to stop him, he'll suck her dry. Mother Earth will be nothing but a lifeless sea of concrete. We can't run away forever.
I get it. That's why I'm here. But there's gotta be a million and one things wrong with altering the path of history. We'll cease to exist. None of this will ever happen. Our lives will.
We're not altering history. We're restoring it. History was rewritten the day that monster was created. We're just a product of that change. A ghost in the infernal machine.
I never thought of it like that. So what? We go back in time, stop the guy, and everything just ceases to exist.
I don't know.
I believe your fellow guardians are going with a less disenchanting theory. The moment we stop the sacrifice and that young girl survives, our reality will switch. Along with it will all our memories. The horrors we've witnessed will simply fade away. We can't say for sure where time will take us, but beggars have no right to choose. Whatever fate we end up with will surely be better than this.
Thanks, boss. You have a hell of a way with words.
Hmm. That's why I call the shots. Now get to it, Agent.
Yeah, this... I don't know whether she's saying that history was rewritten. In order for history to be rewritten, it must first be written in the first place. So... unless... this guy traveled back in time and changed history, and then we're going to change it back. But as far as I know, he just lived in that time and was an apprentice to the other guy in the robe, and then figured out a way to make himself live forever as his friggin' demon. But had no indication that the world was this way in the future, and then he changed it. You know what I'm saying? About the operation. Oh, I got all this stuff. Intel, New Haven. Wow, that's interesting. Tell me everything you know about the Shuggoth.
Tell me everything you know about the Shuggoth.
It was all in the mission brief, Starborn.
Tell me again.
Yeah, that's the one. Run through that one more time.
If you insist. Some 900 years ago, a young man, blind with desire, sought to defy the rules of Mother Nature by spilling the blood of a young royal princess upon the night of the Black Sabbath. He transcended mortality, changing his fate and sealing ours. He did not, however, read the small print, so to speak. The young sorcerer found himself possessed, his mind enslaved by the elder god Shoggoth, his body eternally cursed.
That's
the Shoggoth painted the lands red, passing through kingdoms, killing everything in its path. It wasn't long before the first war came. In a time of great darkness, those who remained banded together in a fight against the Shoggoth, a true army of the people, where blacksmiths, farmers, royals, and mages all fought side by side. The Shoggoth was overrun. His reign of terror stopped dead in its tracks. Except he couldn't die. Despite their best efforts, the Shoggoth was locked away in an anti-magic chamber, buried deep underground. However, the Shoggoth wasn't the only evil in the world. Centuries passed. The world's population grew, and with it came diversity. Many wars were fought, lands conquered, and colonies formed. It wasn't long before the Shoggoth was nothing but a fairy tale. On the morning of the Second Coming, three missiles landed off the coast of what we now know as Seven Haven, one of which directly impacted on the anti-magic chamber, damaging the runes used to block the Shoggoth's power. 800 years had passed since his incarceration. The world the Shoggoth once knew had long since gone. But his hunger was more present than ever. Lost of all but a drop of his former power, it wasn't long before the Shoggoth sought out a new host, a fresh mind to corrupt. Over the next 100 years, the Shoggoth worked his way through society, stealing, killing, and lying his way to the top. By 2050, the Shoggoth had control of the 10 largest corporations in the world, with influence reaching far wider than any government or higher council. He had established a production line of sorts. A new breed. A genetic abomination spliced with the blood of the royals he had once slain. Handled like livestock, these monstrosities were bred and killed for their blood. It wasn't long before the Shoggoth had regained his power. But that wasn't enough. He had bigger ideas.
Wow.
With a wealth of resources at his fingertips, the Shoggoth developed an electrosynthetic virus, a mutagen which multiplied on contact. Once airborne, this virus would spread to those closest to Shoggoth's factories, which would then act as a relay, passing the spores on further. The virus attached itself to the victim's blood cells, flowing through the body and rewriting their genetic makeup. With each day that passed, the virus traveled further, slowly stripping its victims of independent thought and seizing control of their basic motor functions. Before long, the entire population of the Seven Cities had been turned into the Shoggoth's mindless drones.
My God.
This day, there is only one settlement unaffected. The Resistance at Sevenhaven. We lost contact with them 12 hours ago.
An evil that never dies. We'll see about that.